These protests over the death of a black man because of the knee of a white cop, as we've seen, have sparked outrage around the country. Big cities especially are reacting, but one big city is not. The biggest city in New Jersey, Newark, with an African-American population of nearly 50%. So why no upheavals in Newark? The answer is revealing. Here's New Jersey reporter Anthony Johnson.
New Jersey's largest city has seen its share of protests over the death of George Floyd. Saturday night, some 12,000 people hit the streets, but, knock on wood, very little vandalism.
Newarkers stood tall on Saturday night when Newark could have saw another rebellion like in 1967.
The public safety director says the city's residents made their presence known and told agitators to leave.
No, they won't burn our city, Tracy. You damn right they won't.
At one point, they flattened a police car tire, and at least two people in the crowd with the police started telling them, get out of here, you're not from here, get out of our city, don't do that to our police car.
These guys did an outstanding job, outstanding.
This is the first precinct where in 1967 the riot started. On Saturday night, hundreds of people were gathered out here, but the residents of Newark stopped any agitators from trying to overrun this location.
That's something you could never forget.
The mayor's brother was in the crowd with his street ambassadors keeping an eye on the troublemakers.
We stick to the point of why we're here for George Floyd and police brutality and not get into the nonsense.
Today, many people have pride in their city.
It's going to be community clean out. Our officers is tired. Damn it, I'm tired.
State officials have recognized locations like Newark where things remain calm. Now they want to do more to improve police and community relations.
There is only one way to build trust between law enforcement and the community. That's by working at it day after day, year after year.